Phosphorus supplementation is a really big issue in Northern Australia because big parts of Northern Australia are phosphorus deficient, and that has major impacts on cattle production in those areas. Feeding phosphorus supplements has major benefits on cattle productivity and welfare on properties in phosphorus deficient country. Typical things to look for as indicators of phosphorus deficiency is your bone chewing. So that's cattle that are seeking phosphorus and they try and find it through bones. Then they might eat dirt or other strange things. Brittle bones is another really strong indicator. In extreme cases, you'll see peg leg. Higher mortality rates is another indicator. And the other thing is just reduced performance generally. So lower pregnancy rates, and that's because of lower body condition and lower growth rates in your heifers, lower growth rates in your steers, and lower weaning weight because of the lack of phosphorus in the milk and less milk volume. We recently completed a phosphorus supplementation research program at Kidman Springs, which is one of our research stations, and that showed some really amazing benefits from feeding phosphorus. What we did, we split up heifers from weaning into two groups, and one group got phosphorus in their supplement year round and the other group never got phosphorus. And then we compared their performance over 5 years and looked at their growth and their fertility, their calf production over that 5 year period, and also their mortality rates. The results from this work were really quite staggering. Essentially, one treatment, the plus P treatment, was doing really well. They looked great, and the other treatment was doing terribly. We saw higher growth rates in the plus P heifers so that they were heavier during their maiden mating period, and that resulted in higher pregnancy rates. And then we saw really huge differences when they calved and mated again the following year. And so we only had 5% get back in calf in minus P, but we had 30% get back in calf in plus P. By the end of the trial, the cumulative mortality rate was 13% in minus P and only 1% in plus P. In the final year of the trial, we saw really big differences in the pregnancy rates between the two treatments. So in the lactating cows, it was about 60% higher in plus P than minus P. And when you include the dry cows as well, the pregnancy rates were 39% higher in the plus P treatment. So really big differences there. One of the things that happens when cows are phosphorus deficient is that they don't produce as much milk, and so that then follows through that your weaning weights are lower. And so what we saw in this trial, in the first year, the average calf weaning weight was 34 kilograms lower in minus P than plus P, and in the last year it was 43 kilograms lower in plus P. So we started off with about 90 heifers per treatment, and so over the whole period of the study we weaned more than 12 tonnes more weight of calves from the plus P treatment than the minus P. All these things add up to having a really major impact on the profitability of a cattle station in a phosphorus deficient area. So you've got your higher growth rates, you've got your higher pregnancy rates, you've got lower mortality rates, so you have more cull cows to sell and they're heavier. Just in the 5 year study that we did, we found a benefit in terms of return on investment. So for every dollar that we spent on phosphorus supplement, we were getting back $7.66 in terms of extra calf weight in the value of that weight. If a producer suspects that they might have a problem with phosphorus deficiency, the best test we currently have is what's called the blood PIP test, which is plasma inorganic phosphorus. And that's a pretty simple test where you collect maybe 20 blood samples and send them off to a lab, and that will tell you the phosphorus levels in the cattle. There's a few caveats around how you collect and which animals from, but those things are pretty simple, and you can pick them up from your local extension officer or beef advisor. When producers are deciding to undertake phosphorus supplementation, there's a few things to keep in mind. I guess the logistics of how you are going to put it out, especially during the wet season if you've got areas that are difficult to access. There's various different ways you can supplement. You can put out loose mix under sheds, you can put out bulker bags out in the open, and then there's lick blocks that are a bit more robust in the wet season. But it's really up to a property to find out what works best for them. The other thing to keep in mind is the quality of the phosphorus supplement. Certainly rock phosphates are really poor quality, and generally your MCPs and MDCPs are the best. So do a bit of research and make sure you're getting a good bang for your buck. Take home message for producers in phosphorus deficient areas is that feeding phosphorus can have one of the biggest impacts on the profitability of your business, of anything you do. There's increased performance of your cattle, increased productivity, increased welfare, and that all flows on to higher profitability.